6 a.m. already, and the light's coming up.
Oh, I'm tired, but the voice was right. It's time to go. We're gonna be tooling around Mammoth Lakes, California today on a Saturday morning, and I wanna beat the crowds, starting with a Devil's Postpile. By the way, I'm Glenn with the Cactus Atlas. Let's go. Apparently it's only 12 miles away, but it takes a half hour to get there, so must be slow speed limits. That's pretty quaint here in Mammoth Lakes, California. I like it. So far, but of course, we'll see what it's like when the crowds and the people are out. And then I might be talking Tahoe talk again. So there is a little twist, I think, to today's Devil's Postpile that might make it different from many other people's videos. And what that twist is we're past the season, just past the season, where they have the shuttle bus running. Normally, my understanding is you could take a you can't even drive into the monument unless you're camping. You have to take a shuttle that drops you off at a point, and then it's a one-way walk through Devil's Postpile and past something called Rainbow Falls, and you can do it as a one-way hike. Now that that is closed off for the season, there's a short period of time where we're supposed to be able to drive right on into the monument. And this time, though, they don't have the shuttle, so if you were to go all the way to the falls, I think you have to come all the way back. For that reason, we're only seeking out the sign of the devil today, the Devil's Postpile. Beautiful over here. You can see there's a lot of skiing. Oh, look at the ski lift. It goes right over the road. That's awesome. That's really cool. The Cactus Atlas has not tried their hand at skiing, nor have I. I guess I am the Cactus Atlas with Amy, but I'm sure it would be fun. That's really cool. So I guess we're in for a scenic drop. Oh my gosh, look at that. The Eastern Sierra Nevada. Good morning. Good morning to you. Wow. Half a mile from the Postpile, so I was thinking a postpile makes sense. That's a good name for it, because it is a pile of posts in a way. I just saw taillights, so there's somebody else racing towards the Postpile other than me. I think I see we're coming up on it. Less than a half mile, my heart is beating in anticipation. See some like signs over here. Maybe this will guide me to the right starting point, but according to all trails, the direction is this way. To get to the trailhead, I'm should be very close. Man, it's cold. It's not often that you see my breath on the Cactus Atlas. So here we go, folks. The Devil's Postpile trailhead. The Devil's Postpile Trailhead is a short walk from one of the world's most stunning geological formations. It's also a gateway to hell. I mean, the vast Ansel Adams and John Muir wilderness areas. I started my All Trails app and started clocking the route. I think we're dealing like with a mile and a half-ish or something like that, so not a big deal. Maybe we'll get lucky and we will have it to ourselves, I don't know. Actually found it, and there's nobody here. The Devil's Postpile. One way I might describe it is almost like Devil's Tower. You know how the sides are all like ridged? It's kind of like that. That is fantastic. Look at that. When we see it from up above, I think you'll see the hexagonal shapes that really make it impressive and unlike anything I've seen before. Oh my, I didn't even realize. They bend too, you see that? That is wild. So you have like upright columns, and then as you go this way, it's like they bend, and then they twist, and then you see the bottoms of the columns. So basically it's just saying that this whole basin was filled with lava about 100,000 years ago as it cooled. Cracks formed, and they formed one of nature's most efficient and stable shapes, hexagons, as they cooled. And it's one of the world's finest examples of visible basaltic columns in the whole world. Now, we're standing up top. The Devil's Postpile. You see it? You see the hexagons? They're not all perfectly shaped. They've been weathered, I think, with time. Look at this. You know what it reminds me of? Indiana Jones in The Last Crusade, where he's in that room and he has to spell, I think, Jehovah, and he chooses a J instead of an I. I think because it's Latin. And the trap falls when he's trying to find the Holy Grail. At the end, it's like, I, oh, whatever, boom. You're not a hexagon, you're a pentagon. You're not allowed here. The Devil's Postpile delighted me. This was a delight, is how I would call it. The whole morning has been a delight so far. Let's hope the good luck continues. Yeah, down here at the bottom, you really can see the columns, see? Like the full-on columns that, with time, probably just break off one by one with ice and erosion. And there's a little squirrel that's agreeing with everything I'm saying. He's saying, you're correct. And it makes a big pile of what we're calling posts. The Devil's Post Pile. Devil's Postpile gets an A+ from me. I love this. Oh, but
We have to go find our next location here in Mammoth Lakes. We're on a time frame, baby. A time frame. All right, Devil's Postpile. You rock. Get it? You rock.
I saw this from way up by the Postpile, and it's part of the PCT, the Pacific Crest Trail. I think it's the crest, right? Anyway, we're technically hiking the PCT for just a moment to get this view of this meadow here. Meadow magic in the morning. Let's just look at these beautiful columns. These are on their sides over by the bridge on the PCT, if you're looking for it. Nobody advertised these to me. These might be some of the coolest ones, actually. You really see the long columns here. I just walked right by it and didn't even notice when I went on the bridge. I believe there's one way in and one way out of the Devil's Postpile. It's like the Roach Motel. You can get in, but you can't get out. So what did you guys think of the Devil's Postpile? Did you know about it already? Did you ever see anything like that before? Did you know anything like that existed? Comment down below. I'm really curious because I really didn't know about that thing until very recently, and until now I only thought that was the stuff of like fantasy video games and things like that. I've seen that kind of design in many video games and movies and things like that, especially the Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade connection I made. It really looked like that on the top. So far Mammoth Lakes is pretty nice. I got here late yesterday and checked into my hotel, got some dinner, and by that point, trying to get that smudge off of the windshield, by that point it was pretty dark and I couldn't really see much, so I'm seeing the Mammoth Lakes area really for the first time in my life. So Cactus Atlas firsts and Glen firsts here. I'm sure for some of you out there watching this, this is not a first. Maybe you're reminiscing your trip and you've been here, and I'm sure you're probably saying, oh man, you missed that, you missed that. And if that's true, then you know what to do. Comment down below and let me know what we missed. Because if you follow us, if you followed us over the years of us doing this, you'd know that we keep our word and we do come back to places. I know it's a bit of a whirlwind tour we're doing here this morning. And I'm doing a little sampling of a few things that you can do in the area, but do know there's much, 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 much more up here. Lots of places that I saw other YouTubers I watch go, and a lot of places I read about and blogs. So spending, I would say, half a morning is kind of how I would classify this. Maybe we could go as far as say half a day, but my day started really early, so I'm trying to wrap this up by mid-morning so we can start heading on the road and get to my next road trip adventure. So I think what we're gonna do is check out a lake. I think there's a couple, look at this, a couple lookout points, things like that, so we can survey the Mammoth Lakes area, hopefully. And that'll be it, but I think it's plenty. Cactus Atlas videos are usually not too short, are they? Look at this, there's more ski lifts. This is so cool. It's like they built the, that's like, I guess people can ski over this bridge. There's a hill. We're under like a ski hill right here or something. And a ski lift goes over it. How cool is that? Ah, now we're getting some views of the mountains. It really opens up over here. There's a bike trail like off to the left too. Imagine that. Just being able to ride your bike up here with those views for exercise or pleasure, whatever. Wow. Very nice. I also knew we'd be driving around this morning, so a lot of this video I figured should be scenic, and I think we found where the scene in scenic is this morning. Wow, and there's snow up on the peaks up here where we're heading. What a beautiful sight. I see one of the lakes that I heard about. Maybe we'll peek at it too. I think it's Lake Mary, the road's named after it. If I'm not mistaken, it's a really big lake and a really good one to kayak in. Another thing I will not have time to do. I actually brought my kayak on this trip and I didn't get to use it at all. So that sucks. I brought it to use elsewhere. But yeah, just no time. All right, I'm gonna stop here because this looks like this is primo. And carbon dioxide hazard area? What the hell's that all about? Anyway, this looks like a $3 million view here.
I wonder if this is the Twin Falls overlook. I was gonna hit it on the way out, but they have all these parking spots marked, and I'm like, you know, I bet you this place gets crowded, so I'm gonna hit it now. And the sign should actually tell us what we're looking at, hopefully. OMG. Look at that view. That is heaven down there. Maybe it's not, it's just a sign about pioneering tourism. That is the view. This is saying that there's like a natural carbon dioxide area here that it comes
continue
out of
on Lake Mary Road for 5 miles
ground or something, and it can be fatal. I've never seen any such thing like that before. It's kind of frightening. It can be fatal and you don't even realize it. And there's quite a few people already, so I was wise in starting early. Even in this off season, man, it's like this area is more crowded than most other places I've been on this whole trip. So I guess there is no rest.
Yes, I've arrived.
Yeah, I know, I've arrived. All right, our first lake visit here at Mammoth Lakes in the Eastern Sierra. What a view. Let's see what we have going on here. See what I wanted to do. So we're here, and there's a trail that goes out to this guy here. I heard that was pretty good. But Horseshoe's bigger, and I saw a bunch of beautiful ones like Lake Mary, and I think I said Lake Marnie, it's Mamie, on the way out. So when we leave, I was thinking about maybe stopping at these, so now I'm wondering, should we just do boom, 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 and then not that. Horseshoe Lake. What really makes it for me are the backdrops. The mountains with the snow on them, the Eastern Sierra. It looks like there's a loop here at a Horseshoe Lake, which I'm gonna pass on. I am thinking about just driving back down and checking out a couple of the other ones, because I saw the view at Lake Mamie. There were really no cars parked in front of it, but the view looked fantastic with those rocks in the background. I have seen pictures of McLeod Lake, so that formation looks familiar and that would be prominent there. But to save time, I think what we're going to do is we're just going to do a quick lake tour. Starting here at Horseshoe, we're going to make our way back and try to hit one or two more and see which ones we like best. This one was beautiful though.
I know this is very quick and we're just kind of popping our heads here, but I'm keeping an eye on the time also. So I designed a little itinerary, as I always do, for this morning, and I'm tracking right now, but I went over budget on time at the Devil's Postpile because that was so cool that I had to. But my main goal here is I wanted to get a little sampling. I wanted to just take it in the aesthetic and understand the Mammoth Lakes thing, and I think I'm getting it now. I think I'm getting it. And what I'm surveying too is, you know, this would be a kayaker's or canoer's paradise back here. Really calm lakes. None of them so far seem huge. Lake Mary might be the biggest one. I think that might be where we're heading there now. So I might want to check out Lake Mamie or Mammy. I don't know how they pronounce it. It's the next one coming up on the right. Should be coming up right about here. Is there parking? There's parking across the road here, but that is, let's see, maybe I can park in here. Looks like I can. Nice, dude, nice. There's a kayaker going out and somebody fishing too. This looks like a better view, to be honest, than what we've seen so far. This seems pretty nice.
The Twin Falls overlook too? Did we get a double bonus? Here we are, look. Lake Mamie 8898. Almost, we'll say 9. It's close enough. I like whatever that formation is, that really pointy, jagged, dome-like protuberance over there. Because you can get the reflection of that off the lake. It's a little broken. Not quite Bob Ross quality, but not too far off. All right, let's go see what these waterfalls are. Are these the Twin Falls, or am I making that up? Some kind of fall. Good enough to build a bridge to view it, so I'm a buyer. A lake basin path. So it looks like there's like maybe a bike path or something you can go to between the lakes. Oh, wow. I don't think this is like any, this is man-made, I think. But you can see that same overlook that we saw with kayakers down below. How beautiful. So I guess the lake drains out here and you see bridges. What a heaven. Are those the famous Twin Falls? Maybe. Oh, there's a little trolley. This isn't exactly what I was looking for, but maybe it is. I bet it looks better from down there. I see people. See the kayaker down there on his boat or her boat. Kind of crazy that I've already been doing stuff for almost maybe 3 hours or something like that now. But Lake Mamie here seems to be the local fishing spot. Everybody's fishing. Everybody that has a kayak is an angler's kayak. People on the shore. There's a guy right below me right there. You can see in the window. He's fishing. People down there are fishing. You got schnauzers fishing. Everybody's fishing. So I think this was the Twin Falls overlook. I didn't make that up according to Google Maps here. So if this is Lake Mary, this is a beautiful view here.
I don't know if there's anywhere to pull off on the side. These people got it right. Maybe I can. Oh, there's a sign there. That is Lake Mary, 8910. We're going to bypass Lake Mary on this trip. And when I come back, I'm going to kayak Lake Mary or one of these. Because there's something more important that I need to do. And I need to ensure I have enough time to do it. Anyway, so I guess as for a scout, seeing the Devil's Postpile, awesome. Scouting out some of the lakes and just checking out some of the views, double awesome. I got what I needed out of my little short stint here in Mammoth Lakes. It was just a convenient area to stop from to break up a long drive, so it just fit in and it was in the right spot at the right time. And for my drive today, it's, you know, I'm doing everything in halvesies, basically. Having big distances where I was planning on driving all the way through to Phoenix from here tomorrow. I thought wiser of that and changed my plan. Part of why I didn't camp last night. So I guess Mammoth Lakes is what I thought it would be, and it's not what I thought it would be at the same time, if that makes sense. It doesn't. What I mean by that is it might actually be better. Some of the views of the lakes were a little bit better, and it's probably just the nature of when you see pictures and stuff, the scales don't come through, just like my video may not interpret that for you. And now we can view things from up high on the way down as we head back down towards the village down there of Mammoth Lakes. And then after I'm done with my next stop, it will be, I guess, 395 south for a little bit until we head out back into the deserts of Nevada. So take in these last views, folks, of these pines and stuff, because you're probably one video away from brown again. I guess we are in Arizona Channel, so we're not supposed to be this green. We're kind of breaking our rule of adventuring in the Southwest a little bit, I admit. All right, I think we're just very close to where I want to go. And this is a food stop, just to warn you. But I told Google I want to go to Schatz, which is where we're going. Schatz Bakery, I think is what it's called. I think it's a local popular spot, and other YouTubers that I watch pointed it out. So it seems like a tradition for some people. Schatz Bakery. Oh, there's Schatz Bakery and Cafe. I don't even know what I want, but it's not like terribly crowded here. There's parking. It's Schatz. I don't know much about Schatz or what there is to eat in there, but I'm gonna take you in there with me and I don't care. Oh, Schatz. You and I are gonna be friends, I think. Let's go check this out. They got sandwiches and soup and who knows what else. Hi. Do you like Schatz? Do you like Schatz? Do you like Schatz? You love Schatz. Ooh, I see baked goods already. Do you see them? Place in here. I like the art on the wall. You could buy breads too. It would be dried out by the time I get home though. So fresh. All right, well, I can concur with others. Schatz is a must do. Probably a new tradition for me, I must say, if I'm ever in this area for breakfast or for a sandwich next time. Next time it's going to be a sandwich and a split pea soup. I love German food and split pea soup. It's delicious. All right, I have now gone into Schatz, and really quaint place, I like it. I asked the lady what she might recommend, because I First, I wanted to get like a cafe mocha, but their espresso machine's down. I also wanted to get a croissant. I think they've got delicious looking croissants, maybe with intermingled with ham and cheese and stuff. Something savory, but I think they said they were out. Must be insanely popular. So I said, what's good to go with my coffee, and she made a recommendation. But first, let's try the coffee here at Schatz. It's the regular black coffee. You know, I'm particular about my coffee here. Actually, it's quite impressive, I must say. Usually, I'm not very impressed with coffee. This is quite good, I would say. Now, for the grand finale. She said, get an apple fritter. That is the apple fritter. It's gonna be sticky and messy. It's huge. Look how big my head, it's like, there's my head. You see that right there? Amy would be so jealous right now. Should save half of it for her. That's way too much for me to eat, but I got a fork. I don't know how to attack it. I have a bag too. I'm civilized. So let's taste the Schatz apple fritter. And I'll tell you if I'm coming back here or not in the future. They were making fresh bread and all sorts of stuff in there too. Really smelled good in there. Apple fritter. Oh my God. I've never had anything quite like this. It almost has a donut texture, but it's really light and flaky on the inside. And there's real pieces of apple in it. But it's really light like a donut, a fried donut, which I'm not usually a donut person. But it's not overly sweet either. That's why I like it. Where have you been all my life, baby? Look at that. This is next level delicious. I have never had anything like this before, ever. Why? Why are you so good? Well, Schatz has a Cactus Atlas endorsement.
Alrighty, we did it. I accomplished everything I really wanted to see here in Mammoth Lakes on our first crash course tour. And I think Schatz might be the highlight today, and the Devil's Postpile were my two favorite things. Probably Devil's Postpile followed by food. Always natural stuff before food, even if I'm lying to you and it's the other way around. Anyway, I gotta get on the road. I got so much to do, so I'll see you guys again next week. Have fun until then, and happy trails.